Chapter 13, Section 1, The Nature of Gases. So the kinetic molecular theory of gases will help us to understand how we're going to treat gases in the ideal state. So kinetic means that something is moving. In this picture, it's just little BBs that are vibrating. You can see their motion because you have kind of a blur of where they were. Kinetic energy is the energy of an object because of its motion. And the formula for kinetic energy is 1/2 the mass times the velocity squared. The mass has to be in kilograms, and the velocity is in meters per second. And when we look at the abbreviated form, it's 1/2 mass times velocity squared. And the units we use are joules, which are kilograms, meters per second squared. So one of the premises of KMT, or kinetic molecular theory, is that the particles in a gas are considered to be small, hard spheres with an insignificant volume. So we're saying whatever atoms or molecules you have, they're very, very small and don't take up much volume. The second premise of kinetic molecular theory is that these gas particles are in constant, rapid, random motion, and these particles, because of this motion, possess kinetic energy. Our third point is that all collisions between particles in a gas are perfectly elastic. And what that means is that when you have an elastic collision, there is no loss of kinetic energy. So energy can be transferred from one atom to the next. Our next premise is that there are no forces of attraction or repulsion between gas particles. So there's no van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonds, or dipole-dipoles. We're going to assume there's no attraction. So this shows you that the average kinetic energy of gas particles depends on the temperature of the gas. And this video, which was taken from our AP chemistry book, just shows you how that energy can be transferred. If we look at that energy in a graph form, we have number of molecules on the vertical axis and energy on the horizontal. And we see that the colder sample has a peak. This is where the average number of molecules will be. And as it warms up, notice that you kind of flatten out the curve. And if we warmed it up even more, we'd get an even flatter curve. So we get pressure just due to collisions with the box, the balloon, whatever you're holding your gas in. That is what pressure is. If we're out in space, we have a vacuum and there are no collisions. Our atmospheric pressure that we feel is due to the number of molecules pushing down on the surface of the Earth. So you can see from this diagram that at sea level you have lots of molecules, and as we go up in the atmosphere there's fewer and fewer, so the pressure decreases. Now we measure air pressure with a barometer. This is a mercury barometer, and the mercury is affected by the outside air pressure. This is imagine taking a test tube, filling it with mercury, and then turning it upside down in this mercury reservoir, and this forms a vacuum. And as the air pressure pushes, you can see that the mercury go up the tube. This is an aneroid barometer, and it has a spring behind its needle, and that spring's attached to a box, and that box changes as the temperature changes. It either expands or contracts, and the spring is attached to the needle. And if you're reading one of these, you flick the cover of it and you'll get your new reading for your pressure. This is just another barometer that you might see in someone's home. You can see the room pressure is up at the top, the internal pressure is within the bulb, and it's the height of the liquid. As the room pressure increases, it's going to push this bulb down and up into the reservoir. So we have standard atmospheric pressure units, and these are just easily obtained pressure values in the laboratory. These are all equivalent amounts, and you need to be able to convert from one to the other. The Pascal, which is this third one down, is the international unit, and everything else is just a conversion of it. So let's do a quick problem. I would like to convert 700 millimeters to atmospheres. So I know that one ATM is equal to, if I look at my list, 760 millimeters of mercury. So I like to use unit analysis and take 700 millimeters of mercury, and to convert it, I'm going to take one ATM and divide it by 760 millimeters of mercury. We divide it through and we get 0.921 atmospheres for our pressure. So we could use any of those other equivalents to do conversions. So, a little bit more on gases, the nature of gases in kinetic molecular theory, is that the gas will always fill whatever container it's in, whether it's a Kung Fu Panda or a box. Gases are fluids, so you can pour a gas out. Gases have low density compared to their liquids or their solids. If you're interested in seeing the video on the Hindenburg, you can just go to YouTube and search Hindenburg. I showed it in class, and you can see this Zeppelin that flew to the United States in 1937 and had an accident where there was a spark and the hydrogen in it exploded. Gases are also compressible. Something else that gases do is that they diffuse, and diffusion is the spontaneous mixing of particles of two substances, and it's caused by their random motion. And so because gases move all over the place, if you have one gas, it's going to diffuse into the other. Some examples of diffusion include cooking. It also includes perfume, and it also includes when you go to the gas station and you can smell the gasoline vapors. Our last term that you need to know is effusion. And effusion is the process by which gas particles under pressure pass through a tiny opening. Think about getting a little puncture in your bicycle tire. That would be effusion. And with effusion, your gases with faster molecules are going to flow through the tiny pinholes faster than the gases with slow molecules. This is a balloon for research in the stratosphere, way up high. So when is effusion used? We use it for separating helium from oxygen. Remember, helium is a very small atom. We also use it for separating uranium isotopes as volatile uranium hexafluoride. That's the end of our first section in gases, and section two will be on liquids.